Good morning, everyone. Once again, good morning to all of you.
Good morning, ma'am.
Children, now please listen carefully that we have already done our chapter number one, which is building with bricks. Now we are not starting chapter number two, we are starting chapter number three. Chapter number three is about trip to Bhopal.
Ma'am, why we are not doing second chapter?
Second chapter we will do it later on, because that is the reason I am telling you in this, why we are learning chapter three first, not the chapter two first. Children, you already know that in chapter one we have connected the shapes. And the numbers, because in first chapter we have learned the number system also, so that our mathematics in all the classes go smoothly.
If you know, we have to write in notebook.
Did I have written anything in the board? Dhwani, don't come in a hurry in my class. Come on time. Come on time and listen the class, what the instructions are given in the beginning. Okay. Now I want you to please stable yourself, not do much movements. Yes. So what is the reason why we are doing chapter 3, trip to Bhopal? Because in this chapter, we are going to learn all the mathematics operations. What are mathematics operations? You all know addition. Mohin, Kuleri, please sit at your place. You all know addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. These are the basic mathematic operation. Without this, you will not able to find out the calculation, or you will not. No, Shivani, just listen. You have joined late. I request you people, children, please join on time. Otherwise, if you not join on time, you disturb in between the classes and keep on asking the same question and again. Diva, Viha, I request everyone, please turn on your camera and sit in my class. Otherwise, you are allowed to leave my class, no problem. Why we are doing trip to Bhopal? We are doing this chapter because in this chapter, we are going to learn all the basic four mathematic operations, which are addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. So I think after the number system, after Roman numbers, number system, I want to introduce about these concepts. That is why I started this chapter, trip to Bhopal, first, and then we learn the second chapter later on. Am I clear to you all why we are doing this third chapter first before the second chapter? Because we are going to learn these four basic mathematic operations in this chapter. Am I clear? When you read this chapter, you will come to know that there is in one, because in NCERT books, all the concepts are given in the form of story. Right here also in trip to Bhopal, there is one story that one school is going for a trip, and they are going for a trip to where? They are going for a trip to Bhopal. Okay, so here when they are going for a trip to Bhopal, they will use these all basic operation. For example, if I ask from Jignesh, when you go to any trip, which all the things you plan?
What, ma'am?
When you go for a trip, any trip, before going to a trip, what all the things, questions comes in your mind?
We will play there, enjoy there.
Yeah. How you will go, that you will not discuss?
Yeah, we will go by a plane or a train.
Yeah, that also comes in my mind, how we will go. Either we go by plane or we go by train or we go by bus. And now, how many members are we? If we are 10 members, are we all able to come in that bus? Are the all 10 member seat available in the bus? हो सकता है कि बस भर गई है पूरी. बस में 10 seats नहीं है, 5 ही है. But you are 10 people, right? In that bus, in particular bus I'm talking about, not in all the bus. In particular one bus, जिसमें आप बात कर रहे हो and want to go in that bus, but there is a seat for only 5 people. And you are in the family, there are 10 people to go all together. So what do you think? You will think in that mind that we all will go together, we will not go separate. That also come in your mind or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Then you think for the next bus in which we all can come together. These all the question, how much is the ticket for one person? If one person ticket is 20 rupees, then how we will find out for the 10%? How much is the amount for 10%? What you will do in that
multiplication
case? So multiplication is coming or not? Yes. And if you are 10 people sitting in one bus, now if you are 40 people, 10 in one bus, how many buses you need?
4.
Or multiplication is coming?
Yes.
The price of one ticket, other students also please answer me. I'm not teaching one or two students, I'm teaching the whole entire class. Now Asta will tell me. Asta, the ticket price of one ticket is rupees 30. What is the price for 10 tickets?
Ma'am, 3.
One ticket is 30 rupees. Price for
300.
Yes. So here you have multiplied. Multiplication is also repeated addition. But why we are learning multiplication, both the operations separately? Kyun learn kar rahe? Why we have done addition also and we are learning the multiplication also? Why? As you all know, both addition is the multiplication is the repeated addition. Then why there is a need of learning the multiplication? We can do the calculation with addition also.
Because we can guess the answer fast.
We can get the answer fast, our calculation fast. Got it? So all this, when you open after my class, when you open this chapter and read something about this chapter, there is a story going on about they are going for a trip to Bhopal. Bhopal is what? Who will tell me?
Mama city.
A place. A city.
Okay. Bhopal is a capital. Bhopal is the capital, it's a city, is the capital of which state? Bhopal is the capital of which state?
Ma'am, Kolkata.
No.
Ma'am, Uttar Pradesh.
No. It's Madhya Pradesh.
Ma'am, Madhya Pradesh. Yes, I was saying that.
Madhya Pradesh. Bhopal is a capital of Madhya Pradesh. And you all know the capital of Gujarat?
Gandhinagar.
And ma'am, India is Delhi.
Ma'am, India, Delhi.
Yes. So you all are a little bit aware about the capitals and states also, right? So in this, why we are learning about the capital and states? Because it is not only defined that ki hum ye sirf SST mein hi pad sakte hain. No. We can correlate it here with the mathematics also, right? That's why we have just recall our states and capitals. So it's a capital of Madhya Pradesh. Now, they are going to Bhopal. They are planning for many things. So that is why addition, multiplication and division, all this required, all these operation requires. So I am not going directly to the chapter. First, I want to revise the addition topic with you all. Right? Addition, before starting the addition topic, I want to tell you some rules of addition, some properties of addition. What are that properties which I will explain? You may, no need to write, just listen and observe. I can ask the question from any child. And in between, no child will ask, ma'am, do we need to write? When it is required to write, I will instruct you. I will tell you, now start opening your notebook and write. In between, before my instruction, no one will ask, ma'am, do we need to write what is there on the board? Am I clear to you all? Show me thumbs up. Yes. till that, if I'm not telling you to write till that, you just only moksh. I just now told no need to write, just listen here. No need to write, just listen here, observe here, understand the concept. So first rule of addition is when we add n zero to any number, right? For example, I am not going to start with the smaller numbers. I'm going to start the concept with the larger numbers because the concept is already clear. You have learned addition in grade 2 also, in grade 3 also. But I am going to start with the larger numbers as I have already introduced you about the larger number system, right? For example, if I take 12,345. If I want to add zero in this, means I'm not adding anything in this. So what will be the answer? Zero means nothing. So if you are adding nothing in this, so what will be your answer? Laksh Dhola will tell me. Laksh, mute your mic. Laksh, mute your mic. I explained the question. You should be ready for this simple question. Once you turn on your camera, your answer should be quick.
Ma'am, I can, sir.
No, Laksh only will give me the answer. There are some students who hide themselves and they are not answering in the classes. Laksh, please tell me, if you adding zero to this number, what will be your answer? Get yourself ready with the answer and then tell me. Laksh, what, ma'am, what? I have repeated the question 3 times. If you add 0 to any number, suppose any number you have. If you add 0 to that number, what will be your answer?
Zero.
How zero? If you have 10 chocolates with you, then after that you have not added anything in this. You have added 0. Not added any. So how many chocolates are with you? Laksh Dhola, you have attended grade 2. You have attended grade 3. This is the simple question which I am asking from you. If you have 10 chocolates with you, for example, forget about this. If you have 10 chocolates with you and you have not added anything in that, not at zero, at number of zero added. So what, how many chocolates are with you now?
10.
Got it? So when we add nothing to that number, zero means nothing. So what will be the answer, Arav Apani?
12,345.
Yes, I want this type of quick answer. Very good. Got it, Lakshya? If you add zero to any number, the same number will be the answer. Yes, Moksh, what will be the answer here?
12,345.
Shivani, is he correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you try one more example when you add zero to that number? Can you try one more example and give me?
Yes, ma'am.
Please try.
4,000 plus 0 equals to 4,000.
Yes. Got it, Laksh, now? When we add 0 to any number, the same number will be the answer. Hare, got it now? How to add this? Give me one example.
Yes, ma'am.
The zero property. Faster. Give me one example, Hare, fast.
5,000 plus 0 is equal 5,000.
Yes. So I think zero property is clear to you all. Show me thumbs up. Hiya, Vedi, Dhwani, Viha, please turn on your cameras. Now comes to the property of 1. When we add, for example, 766 plus 1, what will be the answer given by Diva?
Yes, ma'am.
What I have written here?
766.
What you need to do?
We have 2 plus 1.
What will be the answer?
767.
So have you observed here, children, when we add 1 to any number, the answer is the successor of that number. Yes? When we add 1 to any number, for example, if I have 9 chocolates with me, I will add one more chocolate. I will get the 10 answer because the successor of 9 is 10. Got it? Now, the next one. If I want to do, for example, 45 plus 50, what is the answer? Tell me.
If I
change their order, if I write 50
here,
very good. If I change their order, if I write 50 first and then I write 45.
95.
Then only 95. Yes. Is there any changes when we change the order of the
side are changing?
If we change the order of the numbers.
The question side are changing.
Mute yourself now, everyone. If we change the order of these numbers, then also the answer will not get changed in addition. Got it? Okay. And in addition, you will get some words more than, okay, added. Then also you need to add. For example, if I say 200 more than 900. So means you need to add 200 in the 900 and get the answer. Clear? When you say that 79 added in 846. So you need to add the 79 in 846 and get the answer. Please add and get the answer. Why I am not writing 79 here? Why I am writing 79 here? Because these are having ones, tens, hundred places.
Yes, ma'am.
And this is ones and tens places. So this should go under the tens. This should go under the ones. Add them. Nothing is here. Put the zero. Add it and tell. This you do in the rough notebook, not in your math notebook. Or if you have any back page of your notebook, do it there and find the answer. Hare, you are not simply sitting here in the class. Please don't sit simply in the class. Sit properly.
Ma'am, we can do in the revision notebook.
Yes, you can do in the revision notebook or a rough notebook or the back page of your notebook. Find out the answer and tell me.
Ma'am, this sum?
Yes.
Ma'am, 925.
Who has done this?
Ma'am, me.
Okay.
Ma'am, please write 925.
So 6 plus 9 is what? 15. 5 will come here, 1 will go carry over. 7 plus 1 is 8 plus 4 is 12. And 8 plus 1 is 9. 925. Got it? Now. I want to introduce some words. What do we call them? If you have the numbers, like you are having 849 and then another number is 79. You have added this. Please, when you add, write the place values at the top. It is compulsory to write. When I will send you the worksheet, please do it in your notebook. Write them properly with the question and answer with their proper place values. And when
can we take a print of worksheets?
No. I strictly told no to taking the prints. When it is required, hardly required to take the prints. This jo aap draw nahi kar sakte, which is kind of a drawing. Then in that case, you take the prints. Because I want to see everyone's handwriting. I want to see how you children are doing your work neatly. In worksheet, I'll not able to see whether your work because you just type. In that case, I'm not able to see which child is having the doing neat work or the good work. So I request everyone to please do your maths work in notebook only. Now,
but this answer will be 928.
Yeah, this will be 928 because I changed the digits, no problem. But I just want to introduce here, these numbers are called what in the addition? First group of numbers, second group of numbers, these numbers are called what? इसी से ही बनता है एडिशन से ही कुछ वर्ड बनता है आई गिव यू अ हिंट
एड
मैम सम
सम इज द आंसर ऑलवेज रिमेंबर सम इज द आंसर बट व्हाट दीस टू
एडिटर एडिटर
नो इट एडेंड्स ए डबल डी ई एन डी एडेंड वन एडेंड टू और अगर थ्री होगा
मैम आई थॉट आई नो दैट आंसर इज सम आई फॉरगॉट फर्स्ट
सो ऑलवेज रिमेंबर ये एड से ही बना है एडेंड वन एंड एडेंड टू ओके एंड व्हाई आई एम राइटिंग एडेंड नॉट एडेंड्स बिकॉज दिस इज वन ग्रुप ऑफ एडेंड दिस इज सेकंड ग्रुप ऑफ एडेंड सो आई एम नॉट पुटिंग द प्लूरल फॉर्म आई हैव ऑलरेडी रिटन एडेंड ओके एडेंड वन एडेंड टू इफ इट इज मोर देन टू ग्रुप्स So you will write add in three also. Jada group ko add kar rahe hain. Agar more than three, add in four also. Am I clear to you all? This is answer always in addition is called the sum. Clear? Now we come to the word problems in the and I request you please always write the statement in the word problems. Story problems mein statement is compulsory. Because when a story is given to you, until you will also not explain in the form of story, I will not able to understand what you have given.
Ma'am, what problem we have to write in notebook now?
No.
Ma'am,
Ash Keshwani, you join late.
Ma'am, 11:01.
Okay.
Ma'am,
let me take the attendance once again. Wait a minute, then I will listen. Yes, someone is asking something.
Yes, ma'am, I was asking.
Mm-hmm.
Ma'am, you will write the word problems we have to that we have to write in the maths notebook or revision notebook only?
Maths notebook. The worksheet which I will send, that worksheet completely in the maths notebook only. Every day, whenever I send the worksheet, that to be in the notebook only, maths notebook. Mm-hmm. Now.
Ma'am, your camera is off.
This may be network issue is going on, beta, my dear. Am I visible to you all, everyone?
Yes,
ma'am. Ma'am, your camera is on.
Ma'am, you are not visible, but your board is visible.
I am not visible because I am just tilting
yes,
this side.
Ma'am,
ma'am board is... you are not visible, the board is visible.
Ah, Shivani, I got it. Please mute yourself now. Viha, log out and log in quickly, fast. So as I am discussing about the word problems, about the story problems, I want to frame one story that a farmer. The story was discussed and given by one of the great, another great child only. He has made one story that there was a one farmer and in his orchard, he is having some apples. Okay, he is having some apples. There was a one farmer. He is having 9,534 apples in his farm. Okay. Now, yes, please go. Apples in his farm. And then in his farm, he is having some mangoes also. Mangoes, he is having 1,296 mangoes. Okay. So I will write number of apples statement number for number I write no dot is the short form for the number. No dot. No, no, you just understand and then you need to frame your word problems and write in the chat box. Number of apples were this much. Number of mangoes were this much. Now, they are asking, total fruits, tell me. How many total fruits in his farm? Add them and tell me the answer. Total word. All together word or find the sum. If you see these words in the question, this is the hint given to you for the addition.
Ma'am, you have to find the answer in the chat box.
Yes. See children, when you read the word problems, when you get the word problem mix. Children, when you are in the class, please come prepare. In between, you please do not disturb the other students that drink water, going for the washroom. Please come prepare in the classes. Now, I am explaining you that when you see the word problems, you will not get separate in your exams, in your assessments, in your CETs. Sometime we take all, like in this chapter, I will teach you addition also. I will teach you subtraction also. So I will give you the word problem mix. So how you will find out whether the word problem is of addition or of multiplication or of subtraction. Some hints I am giving you, you will able to find out the word total, all together, find the sum. These words are the hints for the word problem of addition. Am I clear? Yes. When it will come in the mix, you will find with these words, this is for addition. And if I say, for example, start doing and write the answer in the chat box. And I want each and every child frame one problem, word problem, by their own in the chat box.
Excuse me, ma'am, I still...
Dwani, your answer is wrong. We have... Yes, what happened?
I still cannot see your screen.
You pin my screen. You pin on my screen.
I have pinned, but it's not showing.
Then I can't help you. What I do now? You can hear me, no? Yes, Shivani, you have used something else for the zero. So please check. Viha, I was explaining to the student that frame one word problem based on addition. In the chat box.
Okay.
Suppose I went to the bank. In one month I deposit 1,000. Second month I deposit 2,000. So how much total amount in my bank? Word total is coming. How much total amount is in my bank? 1 month I deposit rupees 1,000. Yes. Second month, I deposit 2,000. So after 2 months in my bank, there are 3,000. So it is in rupees. Always see that you need to write the unit properly. Okay, that will be in rupees. Here it is fruit, so no need to write the unit. For example, if it is kg, the 9,534 kg apples, 1,296 kg apples. If it is kg, if it is not in numbers, it in kg, so what you will do? So your answer one, you were adding, no, 10 9 10 11 to 13 5 6 7 8 and 10 830 kg. So unit is compulsory to write. Am I clear to you all? If I change this question that these apples are not in numbers, these are in kg, and these mangoes are also in kg. So when you add them, your answer should have a unit, which is proper unit given in your question, kg. And if we are talking about the rupees, for example, if you have taken one shirt, which is of 400, okay, one trouser, which is of 600 rupees, one 400 rupees shirt, 600 rupees shirt, trouser, how much total amount you spend? How much total amount you spend? 300 for shirt and 400 for shirt and 600 for trouser. So how much total amount we have used? And please don't forget to write the unit. Which unit will come here? If I am talking in rupees, so what you will do here? Give me answer. 400 plus 600 is 1000. So only not write the 1000 is correct. Is not correct. You need, yes, Jignesh. Number of bats, number of balls. Very good, excellent. Add them also and give the answer.
No, I have written total.
Yes, 1000, which I was explaining, 1000, only 1000 is not correct answer. Rupee 1000, rupee sign will come. Dollar sign, please don't put. Rupee sign, please put. And please, that also to be before the number, not after the number. Yes, right now I can understand.
Laptop, so I can put the sign.
Okay. So please put the rupee sign and I also, the number.
Also in laptop, so I can put the rupees.
Okay. So got it, children? How to solve the addition, word problems, and problems with carryovers, right? So I'm going to send you, if any doubt, please ask me, and I'm expecting from everyone to frame one word problem and addition and write it in the chat box.
Ma'am, we can write RS.
Yes, you can write RS, that will be understandable, but please write rupee, current rupee sign which we are using right now. You all are doing? Yes or no?
Ma'am, we have to frame our sentence, no?
Yes,
ma'am. Ma'am, and we have to put the answer also, no, over there?
Yes. In the chat box, you need to write the answer also.
Ma'am, I write the answer.
Very good.
Ma'am, we have to write that in the notebook.
No, no, you can write in the notebook also, but show me. Once you are done with the notebook, then show me. I will read your note, your question.
Ma'am, I'm doing a chat box.
Okay. Yes, total cricket, I think, are this much amount. Very good. Only Jignesh question is in proper way. I want from everyone.
Ma'am, my answer is correct, no?
Let me check once more time. Four, six, seven, eight, nine. Yes. So children, we have done today's class. If any confusion, any problem, if you not understood anything in the worksheet, ask me in the next class, okay? Thank
Bye.
You.
Bye, ma'am. Have a good day.
Thank you.